Necesito ayuda.
I need technical assistance.
In everyday life, we could not communicate or understand one another without a common language. The same applies to equipment and systems. We have to make sure they can work together. This is what we mean by interoperability.
The best way to explain it is to look at your cell phone. If every single company that was out there had their own special cell phone meeting their own standards, you could only call people that belong to the same company that you belong to. So we're looking at putting standards out there so that everybody, every nation, Army, Navy, Air Force, can actually exchange information with each other.
And in a NATO operation, it is the 28 member states and their partners who may have to work together, each one using different national standards and formats. So equipment must be harmonized. That allows better information sharing and cooperation.
Interoperability is not just improving exchanges between systems, it's also rationalizing them. If a French drone can carry out a mission for the benefit of all the coalition members, it is not worth the others also sending out drones, or even other sensors to get the information.
For each operation, care must be taken that all equipment is interoperable. So nations develop different ways of testing conformity in exercises to be better prepared for coalition operations. Since 2009, the alliance has had a new test capability, the DNBL, a virtual platform on which the nations are interconnected and can exchange data such as imagery, all managed from The Hague by a NATO agency, the NC3A.
In the DNBL world, we can actually set up a test with an individual or one or two nations relatively quickly. They don't have to transport people or equipment up to The Hague to do the testing. They stay at their home facility. They connect over the internet. We can actually do testing in a week that might take 2 or 3 weeks if they had to transport things up here, do the testing, and then go back home.
With these kind of mechanisms, we will overall save time and effort. And in addition to that, the knowledge gained in the individual test events contributes then to improved quality of the NATO systems, the national systems, and the maturization of the NATO standards, which will have an impact on time and cost too.
Yeah, this is Emmanuel from France. Did you receive my video stream?
Yes, Emmanuel, we have received it.
I'm receiving a video stream from France. It's a good signal. So, Ben, if you could do the analysis of the compliance.
I'll check for compliance now. Interoperability is pretty good.
From The Hague Laboratory, the NATO experts check whether the data sent conform to alliance standards. Other nations must be able to read them and use them. Among other things, they analyze the image compression format. 9 nations form part of the DNBL community, launched in 2009. France was one of the first to join the project. In 2010, it carried out various tests, including the imagery of those Harfang drones used for the operation in Afghanistan. The drones gather strategic information on the theater of operations.
L'Harfang diffuse vers une station sol par une liaison radio dans un format qui est...
The Harfang transmits through a ground station via a radio link using a proprietary French format not known to the community. When the transmission arrives at the ground station, modifications are made there to ensure it's interoperable with NATO, which will allow us to convert this French standard to a NATO standard used by all. In this operation, DNBL allows us to verify the chain from end to end, to see if the conversion from a French standard to a NATO standard is compatible, and indeed interoperable with the core of the system provided by NATO. It allows us, in advance of deployment, to test the chain of systems as if it was deployed, and verify that it works in its entirety, without bringing an operational risk.
Other nations should join this virtual platform. 20 industrial groups are also involved, and can use this platform to verify the interoperability of their systems. The fields of application are varied, for example, cyber defense or simulation and modeling. By 2015, DNBL hopes to extend to more than 200 members from among the nations and industry. This is a NATO Channel report.